Hello and welcome to Method CRM User Tutorials. My name is Errol and today we are continuing our series on Report Designer. And this is part two of pivot grids. In our previous video, we created a pivot grid showing customers' invoices over a period of months. There are many things that you can style in a pivot grid, and I can't cover all of them, but I will go through a couple of things. Here I am back in the property editor, and notice we have a section called printing. In appearances, you can customize the styles of your pivot grid. I'm going to style the headers, so let's change the field value grand total to dark green, and then I'll change the grand total cell to light green. Close that and preview. Ha! Look! Now the totals stick out. Awesome. I'm not going to cover all of the things you can color, I think you get the idea, so let me continue on. Back in the property editor, let me hit printer settings, and this is where you can make the headers visible or invisible. Like the amount header that just hovers there, awkwardly, like I do with my in-laws. It's weird. This is a data header, and I can make it disappear. So, see where it says data headers? I will set it to false. Let me close this and preview, and look! The amount header is not there anymore! I can also make the other headers and lines invisible, but this is good for now. I'm going to go back into the editor because I want to show you layout. Click the layout icon and here you can drag and drop how your pivot grid is organized. Remember we put customer as the row and the transaction date as the column? Under layout, I can visibly switch that. Look, I'll grab the customer field and drag it up to column and then drag the transaction date into the rows. I'll hit apply, and then I'll close this and preview. Look, I swapped the row and columns. It runs off into the next page though. Doesn't look good. So that's why I created it with date as columns and customers as rows. So I'm just gonna go and undo all of that, but you can see where that can be handy. Okay, one more thing I wanna do here. Were you curious and wondered what would happen if you just threw another field into the pivot grid? I was curious, and so I did it. I clicked the double arrow to open up the fields, and I added the sales rep, and I made it into another row. And when I closed and previewed, what magic is this? It automatically groups it for me. I can't see the totals right now, so I'm going to quickly go into the properties of the sales rep row and make it much smaller by changing the width. Preview that, and ha, see? Now you can see why this was so awesome when I first saw it. The sales reps we added are now grouped by customer. And it has little subtotals for each customer. It's so cool. Okay, I'm gonna color the subtotals so I can distinguish them. I'm just gonna do it in the properties over here as opposed to the editor. So with the pivot grid selected, I will go over to appearance, and I will change the field value total to a dark blue, and then change total cell to a light blue. And now when I preview it, hee-hee, look, it's all nice and color-coded. Awesome. One final thing. I think I keep saying that and it's never the final thing. Anyway, what if you want to group your data differently? I can do that through the layout screen. Let me go back there. And notice in the row section, I have the customer and to the right of it, the sales rep field. I can swap that. I can click and drag the sales rep before the customer. I'll apply that, close it and preview. Huzzah! Look what it did! Now it lists all the sales reps, and with each one it lists their customers. It's like magic. So experiment. Go and see what it looks like when you move things around in layout. Look, see? I just drag things around, and when I preview it, this is not good at all. Anyway, you'll be better at this than I am, so make something useful for yourself. And we're done. Wow. Pivot grids are cool. In the next video, I will show you how to use print templates in Method CRM so you can print out these invoice reports that you've been creating. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the YouTube comments, check out our documentation, post on our forums, or you can tweet us at Method CRM. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Bye-bye.